During the afternoon of November 20th, at 3:24 p.m. local time, one of the most dangerous volcanoes on the planet produced a tremendous explosion. As the pressure that had been building up underneath Papua New Guinea's Ulawun volcano was released, a sustained eruption column rapidly shot to a height of 50,000 feet, or approximately 15.2 kilometers. As part of this eruption column, which was heavier than residual air, subsequently collapsed back to the ground, it generated long-reaching pyroclastic flows, which traveled at least 4,340 meters, incinerating an area of approximately 7.3 square kilometers. In the midst of this unusually large eruption, the Japanese Meteorological Agency stated that they were now monitoring what could be a tsunami risk of several of its southernmost islands. Yet, a tsunami thankfully did not occur. Although I am unsure exactly what generated this initial alert, I am guessing it may have been due to potentially misinterpreting the length of a pyroclastic flow the latest eruption created, as these can create tsunamis upon entering the ocean. Or it could have been related to one reason why Ulawun is considered to be a highly dangerous volcano and it relates to its height. As, on the island of New Britain, if you look around, you will see caldera after caldera, indicating fully or partially collapsed volcanoes. Although this is by no means a hard rule that always applies, volcanoes on this island seem to undergo some form of a major eruption or collapse after they pass 1,900 meters in height. And yet, Ulawun stands at 2,334 meters in height, while also containing an undated, although probably younger than 20,000-year-old major collapse score facing towards the north. If this volcano was to hypothetically collapse again, it would devastate a vast area and generate a wide-reaching tsunami. Luckily, in my opinion, there are zero signs of a major landslide, collapse, or tsunami occurring anytime soon at this volcano, so these fears are currently unwarranted. However, there are four other hazards which are indeed a potential problem. Namely, pyroclastic flows, the ash cloud itself, the potential for heavy ashfall, and toxic volcanic gases. More than 12 hours into the eruption, the volcanic plume, which had been largely drifting to the west, reached a new record height of 60,000 feet, or approximately 18.3 kilometers. This marks the still-ongoing eruption as the second-highest eruption plume Ulawun has created in recorded history, only being shorter than the August 2019 eruption, which triggered a 20-kilometer or 12.43-mile exclusion zone. The wide-ranging extent of the ongoing ash plume means it is likely to cause regional flights to be disrupted, with some cancellations, as large volumes of ash are highly dangerous for aircraft. While I was unable to at this time confirm that an exclusion zone was in place, the last time an eruption of this magnitude occurred, more than 15,000 people were evacuated, with an initial 20-kilometer exclusion zone eventually being reduced to 10 kilometers in all directions around Ulawun's summit. Some locals already appear to be evacuating, and I consider this to be a wise course of action. Here is why. While Ulawun has been continuously erupting since July 18th, its eruptive activity had been fairly weak. We can roughly correlate the strength of this eruption to the number of thermal signature satellites detected. Yet, on October 30th, the number of thermal signatures began to increase. This figure continued to rise, reaching its highest level in the 4-month-long eruption 2 days in a row on November 16th and November 17th. Then, the number of heat signatures sharply dropped, indicating the plug had formed. Due to the high magma supply going into the mountain, the volatiles in the mountain built up in pressure until it finally exploded upwards, generating this powerful eruption. There is a decent chance that this plug has not been fully cleared, or if it has, it likely will temporarily reseal itself at least once, meaning more powerful explosions could occur in the next 2.5 months, just like what happened during 2019. The 60,000-foot eruption column which just occurred could also be a one-off event, but I consider this possibility to be less likely. Although the eruption is still ongoing, if I had to estimate its size on the 0 to 9 volcanic explosivity index, I would place it as a 3. As a final note, I would like to thank my new patron, Cole Anthony Cymeri Sutton, for supporting this channel.